Number 5. Left Behind is a 2014 apocalyptic disaster film directed by Vic Armstrong and is based on a series of Christian novels of the same name. The story revolves around a group of individuals with different backgrounds who are left behind on Earth when a mysterious disappearance event occurs. This event is believed to be the rapture, a phenomenon in Christian theology where believers are taken to heaven while others are left on Earth to face catastrophe and chaos. The film focuses on Rayford Steele, a pilot played by Nicolas Cage, who witnesses the outbreak of this event during a special flight and attempts to calm the panic. Passengers will also searching for his own family. The story, told from Ray's perspective, explores themes of faith, hope, and family.
I know you all want answers, and believe me, so do I, and I'll do my best to get them.
I heard some doctors talking. It's not just here. It's all over the world.
One of these days, the sky's gonna break.
Chloe, are you okay?
Yeah, Mom and Raimi, they're both gone.
One of these days, the mountains are gonna fall into...
Irene knew this was coming, the way it happened. How could she know that?
He took them to protect them from the darkest time in the history of this world.
The God my mother talked about would never do something like this.
We all have a right to know if we're gonna die.
No, we're gonna die.
No spoilers, no flaps, no elevators, and if I run this thing dry, no reverse thrust. I need some room. I just really need you to know how much I love you, no matter what happens.
Dad?
Looks like the end of the world.
One of these days, the sky's gonna break, and everything will escape, and I'll know.
Number 4. Just a Breath Away is a 2018 French disaster thriller film directed by Daniel Roby. The story is set in Paris and revolves around an extreme weather event that blankets the entire city in a deadly toxic fog. The fog makes the air unbreathable and poses a life-threatening situation for everyone in the affected area. The film's central characters are a family consisting of parents who are desperately trying to protect themselves and their daughter from this lethal fog while searching for a safe source of oxygen. The narrative is fraught with intense tension, focusing on the family's struggle to survive in this extreme environment. They must face a series of challenges and dangers while attempting to find a way to escape. The movie presents a poignant family drama set in an extreme scenario, exploring the resilience and determination of humans when faced with life-threatening situations.
Rentre dans ta bulle.
Non, non, vous inquiétez pas.
Ça a pas l'air de monter jusqu'ici. Il y en a partout. Ça va perdre de vue.
Il y a des secours?
Non, j'ai rien vu.
Il reste 4 barres de batterie. Et la fumée se dissipe pas.
Elle passe pas la nuit. La brume, elle monte. Ça ira pas mieux. Ça va ne faire qu'empirer. Tu te rends pas compte de comment c'est dehors? Je pense que les 2/3 de la population parisienne y sont passés d'un coup. Et si c'est pareil ailleurs? Il y a des combinaisons spéciales qui permettent aux patients de se déplacer. Et à partir de là, tout est possible. Il y en a pas assez pour comprendre tous les deux.
Number 3. The Happening is a 2008 science fiction thriller film directed and written by M. Night Shyamalan. The story is set in the northeastern United States, where a mysterious ecological disaster unfolds. People suddenly begin exhibiting abnormal behavior, leading to suicides or violent attacks. This bizarre phenomenon spreads rapidly, and the government is unable to contain it, plunging society into chaos. The main focus of the story is on a couple. High school science teacher Elliot, played by Mark Wahlberg, and his wife Alma, played by Zooey Deschanel. They attempt to escape the ecological catastrophe and find a safe haven, while also trying to unravel the mystery behind the events. As the story unfolds, they gradually discover a connection between the disaster and the plant kingdom and seek a way to survive.
Orientation. The third stage is fatal.
Attacks are spreading.
Boston, Philadelphia,
Maryland.
It's all over the country.
Authorities are now feeling that a terrorist group being responsible is becoming less and less likely.
She says everyone's dead outside.
Shut the windows and the doors! Here it comes!
Could this really be happening?
Number 2. Bird Box is a 2018 science fiction thriller film, directed by Suzanne Beer and based on the novel of the same name by Josh Malerman. The story unfolds in the aftermath of a sudden global catastrophe. A mysterious supernatural phenomenon causes people to become extremely manic, leading to suicide or violently attacking others upon seeing a mysterious presence. To survive, survivors are forced to wear blindfolds and rely on their hearing and touch to navigate the world. The central focus of the story is a woman named Mallory, played by Sandra Bullock, who, along with her two children, must navigate this post-apocalyptic world. They seek a safe haven, escaping the unseen terror, while trying to uncover the mystery behind the phenomenon. Throughout this perilous journey, they encounter other survivors and face both human adversaries and unknown threats.
What's going on?
People describe seeing an entity that takes on the form of your worst fears.
Oh my God.
What are you looking at? What did you see? What is wrong with you? Please stop it!
We can't stay here.
Every contact we have had with the outside has brought us death.
Your kids,
they deserve hope.
Every single decision I have made has been for them.
You're going on the trip now. It's going to be rough.
Hold on!
If you hear something in the woods, you tell me. If you hear something in the water, you tell me. But under no circumstance are you allowed to take off your blindfold.
Do you hear that?
Number 1. The Mist is a 2007 horror science fiction film directed by Frank Darabont, based on Stephen King's novella of the same name. The story unfolds in a small town in Maine. After a severe thunderstorm, a thick mist descends upon the area. A painter played by Thomas Jane decides to take his son, played by Nathan Gamble, to the local supermarket to buy essential supplies. However, when they arrive at the supermarket, they quickly discover that the mist is not only thick, but also filled with unimaginable creatures and dangers. People inside the supermarket find themselves trapped in a confined space and constantly face attacks from these creatures. Meanwhile, the fear and pressure among them escalate, leading to internal conflicts and confrontations. The film is known for its suspenseful and thrilling plot, And it delivers a shocking twist at the end that leaves the audience deeply affected.
Then I guess the joke would be on me.
It is time to take sides. Read the good book. It calls for blood.
Guys, I hear something.
Are those bugs?
Not like any I've ever seen.
The entire front of this door is plate glass.
I thought that there were other dimensions. They wanted to try and make a window.
Well, maybe your window turned out to be a door.
Who she's gonna sacrifice to make it all better?
We want the boy.
You try it.
Kill him!